आई एम नम्रता एंड आई रन दिस फाउंडेशन कॉल कलर आश्रम फाउंडेशन विच इज बेसिकली टू स्प्रेड अवेयरनेस अबाउट नेचुरल डाइज एंड ऑल्सो टू ट्रेन पीपल हाउ टू डू नेचुरल डाइंग हर्बल डाइंग इन देयर हाउसेज एज वेल एज इन प्रोडक्शन सेटअप्स ऑल्सो इन इंडस्ट्री. सो आई वॉन्ट टू बिगिन बाय शेयरिंग हाउ डिड वी गेट हियर वेयर वी आर राइट नाउ. So thousands of years ago, we have always been doing natural dyeing as humans, as civilization. Chemical dyeing was discovered only in 1880s and it came to industrial level in 1900s. While I'm talking, if you have any questions, you can write on the chat. I'll be happy to check and answer. So in late 1900s, we discovered the marvelous uses of chemical dyes. It brought so many shades into our lives. It made dyeing very easy. It made dyeing color fast, a cheaper process, and you know, fashion industry boomed because of this. So everything was very nice. We have 1 lakh Pantone shades today, and fashion was booming. Our clothes become more affordable today. If anybody wants to become a designer or wants to start a production, it's absolutely affordable to start. And innovation in chemical dyes has been the quantity in which we manufacture clothes today, the quantity in which fast fashion is churning out clothes. Approximately 1 kg of fabric pollutes 150 times its weight of water. You can just calculate how much of water. So when we talk about rivers, and I mean, I'm so happy to be a part of this because People Foundation is working, the Resilience Lab is working for the cleaning of rivers and for the betterment of people around rivers. So the rivers are the major suffering, bodies where textile pollution is related to, because tons of liquid waste comes out of these factories and is dumped in rivers and it cannot be cleaned. The quantum is so high that it is not possible, and the means of cleaning is so expensive that it is not practical. So today, when we are facing COVID and many such ecological damage issues, we have to understand that it is time that we start taking some care about the damage that we are doing to ecology and water, because it enters our food chain and our lives as poison. The way we can handle this is actually already the answer is there in the past. As I told you, we were dying with natural dyes all the years, just 100 years back. Now, what is the problem with natural dyes is that though the color is beautiful, it comes from nature, it is harmless. Our ecology knows how to digest this color. It will not create poison, because the thing is that in nature, everything balances itself and it makes water, land, air absolutely pure and comfortable for us to breathe and live in. So when we're talking about natural dyes and its application today, in the time and energy that we have today, we have to make some innovation. If we follow the same process, the traditional process of natural dyeing, we can only do a very, very small quantity, maybe at hand level, maybe at small cottage industry level. What about industry level? Which industry today? Look around and see, check on the websites and go and see. Is there any industry which can make and dye and print thousands of meters in a day, just like any other textile industry? So the idea is we need to build industries which can use natural dyeing technology, which means an innovation, which means the same ingredients of natural dye, but the process to suit the machines has to be implemented if we really want the impact to come on the rivers, if we really want impact to come in our lives. If very small quantity of natural dyes are being used, that's not the answer to deal with the quantum of fashion and the requirement for chemical dyes. And also the limitation of natural dyes to do a few shades not able to be standardized. These are some issues why it is not able to come in industry. So while I'm talking about all these problems, I'm also the part of the solution. So my co-founder at Kalra Ashram Foundation is Arun, and he has been a pioneer to industrialize natural dyeing. He was running a company called Aura Herbal Textiles, and now we have set up a new company which is called True Tone Inc. I have already shared the website details here on the chat if anybody wants to see. So we are manufacturing dyes and using a patented process to use natural dyeing on industrial scale. To answer to all the people who are not connected to textile industry and are users, are designers, are consumers, I want to also share that we also have dye kits like this, you know, which is in the background, as well as processes and online workshops, physical workshops for anyone from a four-year-old child to any age. You can learn natural dyeing, herbal dyeing, and you can do it in your house with just a bucket of water and a clothesline. You don't need anything else. The rest of the work which makes natural dyes difficult, which is the whole boiling process, the procuring of resources, how do you store so much of roots and herbs? So natural dyeing, when I talk about, I'm talking about, you know, flowers and herbs like these, you know, which is dried flowers and roots. For example, this is pomegranate peel. This is a peel of pomegranate. Then there is manjishta or madder, which is a root of a plant which gives red color. So there are these many, many resources. But what happens is so many kgs of the raw material will give you a very, very small quantity of dye. How would you store this? How would you boil? By, you have LPG fuel in your homes. How will you boil for hours to take out little color and then dye what? A napkin? A t-shirt? What about the rest of your wardrobe? So the idea is for us, my partner, as I said, has innovated the process and made a mixture, a powder of herbs, which is a ready one-step process of dyeing. Normally, natural dyeing takes several steps and several days to be dyed. We have a one-step process and you can dye your fabrics in 1 or 2 days. So, I mean, we all understand by now that why natural dyes should be used and should be, you know, adopted. But we did not know, or we need to understand of how it can be practical, how it will be suitable to our pockets. How can we work with it? How can we buy it? And how can we recycle at home if we want to? So natural dyeing is actually can be made so simple that you can upcycle your old garments by dyeing them again with these colors. If you see those scarves in the background, napkins and scarves, they are all natural dyed also. We have around 24 shades that we offer, and we can give you many more shades depending on, you know, what you want to develop. So, I mean, in a nutshell, this is pretty much what I wanted to say. One more thing. Natural dyeing, as the speaker before me mentioned, and thank you so much. It was very nice to hear you and learn from you. So as he mentioned, natural dyeing, if done with chemicals or heavy metals, it can again become toxic. So we need to be aware that if you are taking out the color from plants, but you are taking heavy metals to fix it, it is still becoming toxic. So we are here to discuss, as people, organization is working for the ecological balance. We need to understand not just color, we need to also use the fixer, the pre-process, post-process with eco-friendly materials, so that the water which is coming out of your unit is organic. It does not have toxic level, which can disturb the balance. How do we do that? If you're doing natural dyes, do not use chemical fixers. Do not use heavy metal fixers. Try and use the moderns which are eco-friendly, like alum and iron, which again the speaker before me had mentioned. So there are many courses, there are many knowledge, resources online available. There are many teachers around who can teach natural dye. So it is not, I mean, it just needs an interest to do it. Once you're doing it, if you want to work with it at industrial level, if you want to work with a cluster, if you want to work with a group of artisans, you need to go a little beyond the normal traditional way of natural dyeing, because you need a standardized process. For that, I am offering a training at Color Ashram, and you can write to me. I will be sharing my email ID here. I'll be very happy to offer this service to anyone who wants to change. I would also like to mention that natural dyeing language is a language which is different from chemical dyes. We cannot expect the same parameters and the same results as chemical dyes. So the shades which we dye with natural dyes are going to be earthy. They will be very soothing to the eye, but they will not be as bright and vibrant as chemical dyes. You can get a dark red, but you cannot get a fluorescent red. So when you want to go natural, we need to understand, we need to accept all the characteristics and attributes of this language. In nature, nothing is perfect. In nature, things are very soothing. There is no harm caused. Natural dyes similarly are very nurturing. They do not cause any harm. They can be digested and they can be, broken down easily by the enzymes which are present in nature. Similarly, everything has a life. Similarly, natural dyes also have a life. Especially if you're going to use very high alkaline detergents, it's going to fade very fast. So the idea is to use mild and gentle neutral detergents if you're using natural dyed clothing. The limitation of shade is not a real limitation. The problem is, the more research opens up in this field, that we will have many more colors. But for now, we have a limited shade card. Yes, it is not as big as chemical shade card, but it is really enough to satisfy the need of fashion industry. I also have a fashion brand called Biome Conscious Fashion, and I've been making clothes and doing some fashion shows in Kolkata for the last 8-9 years. And I have found that people look beautiful, they accept, and they are very confident wearing natural dyes. It is only that we do not have access to natural dyes, so we do not know. Give any piece of fabric in the hand of a fashion designer, and I'm sure that design can make a huge difference. Besides this, I would like to, I don't know what time it is, it's 3, yeah, I'm almost in time. So I would like to end by saying that at our foundation, we have started this revolution called Color Re-Evolution, which is basically a movement to know about natural colors, to know that there are toxic substances in chemical colors which are destroying our rivers and ecology, to be able to demand industries to change to natural, to be able to support people who are working with natural dyes. The speaker before me and many other people who are doing natural dyes are actually not able to survive many times because there are no takers, there are no buyers, the people don't know about it. So if you can spread the word, if you can help in creating awareness about natural dyes, if you can start wearing, if you can start working with it, we will surely have an option of natural color in our wardrobe. I am not talking about replacing chemical dyes completely. I don't think it's possible. As of now, I cannot think about it. Maybe in future we can. But can we create an option for people to wear, adopt natural dyes as an option? Let's find it in our markets. Let's find it in our wardrobe. So I would urge you to find where natural dyes are available, learn it, enjoy the process and share with people. I'm going to share the link of the revolution. This is an open revolution, which is for everybody who thinks that there should be an option of natural color and we should promote it. Thank you so much, People Foundation, Shubhkamini and Rani Ji. I hope that I've been able to do justice. Do let me know if you have any questions.
So we are inviting questions from the audience. Do you have any questions on this?
Hello.
Yes, I can hear you.
I am Parin Vikas Jain from Pali, Rajasthan.
Right, the most polluted place in Rajasthan, right?
You can say to some extent, but there are so many places in our country that are
polluted. I'm saying so because I had a journalist who has been calling me from Pali, and he says that you know there are so many industries here, and we need to change to natural. Yes, please continue.
There are about 400 dying units, small and big dying units in Pali. So there are some issues with the pollution and outlands in Pali. That's a different story. Actually, just I want to ask one question. Actually, I do on a household basis. I also do natural dyeing, and in my house, I wear my clothes dyed with the natural dyes. So I have a very strong fascination for the natural dyes. I'm doing it for the last 3 to 4 years, and I also doing the eco painting. I think you must have heard about the eco painting.
Yes, absolutely.
I print a lot, but I do not go it for the commercialization. Actually, I did not. I did not want to go for the commercialization. I don't know why, but this is just for my hobby purpose. My question is, Namrataji, is that I have seen many manufacturers of natural dyes, and they are mixing some synthetic dyes in the natural dyes. I will quote particularly alizarin. Alizarin, actually, they sell alizarin that it is extract of madder. But in fact, this is a synthetic dye, and they are using it in Jaipur and elsewhere. You must have heard about this alizarin, I think. This alizarin is, in fact, a synthetic dye, and they are selling it in the name of natural dye. They say that it is extract of madder dye, and there are some other dyes also. They claim that this is natural, but in fact, this is not natural. And I have also seen many shades, dyers they develop that is not possible to be achieved with natural dyes alone. So I my question is that why there is so much jugglery? I mean, say jugglery in this trade, in particularly natural dyes. And second thing is that if we want to shift natural dye into commercial dye into natural dyes, I think, don't you think it is going to create a havoc because it will drastically affect our biodiversity? So this is the question.
Sure.
And also, want to add in this. I also seen many dyers. They are using the dye fixing agent, that is the carcinogen. They are having carcinogens in their compounds. They are also using it in a very great quantity. So these are the things that I think you should make people aware who are going to buy products from you, that this is not good in the name of natural dyes. This is my question.
Yes. So Mr. Vikash and Sudeep, as I can see you're typing, you are absolutely right. Natural dyes can be very poisonous if the processes are not eco-friendly. If heavy metals and chemical fixers are mixed with it, then it will become toxic. So natural dyes, when we work with, we have to keep our eyes open. And there is a way to work without working with these harmful, you know, additives. So if you want to know more about how can you do that, like what, as I said, True Tone Inc., I've given the website name. If you look at our products, we are not using any heavy metals, any chemicals, nothing. It's all, you can take our dyes and test it in laboratory, get it tested. We claim to be completely natural. So you need to ask your natural dyer or the source where you're taking from that, can you give it to me in writing that there is no toxic chemical used in this process? That's the answer. That's the way you need to find out from them. I can give it to you in writing. We can give it to you in writing. That is to answer your question. Secondly, about the havoc that you're saying, if we shift. No, the natural dyes are made, which we are making is from the wild waste of nature, of agricultural waste, and it's not from the edible portions. And so it will not affect the food that we eat. So we're not going to use the food material. We use the peel of pomegranate, the onion skin, the tea, and you know, a lot of more waste dry flowers from nature. And if you're talking about that, should we change completely to natural dyes and what will happen then? I don't know about that really. And I don't think it's possible to completely change. But we should have another option. We should have a parallel industry. Let us at least begin. It is not even there. If you look at the quantum of clothes, where is natural dye clothing? If you go in a public place, you just stand there and look around and see if you can actually spot or find any one person wearing natural dyes. It's not there in the market. We need to bring it in the market. Let there be competition. Let us have a healthy competition and see what happens. At least let us begin. So these issues of what is going to happen when it changes, I don't know right now. But I can tell you this, that the answer is also in going slow fashion. We cannot be making so many and demanding so many clothes as fast fashion. That is not a way that we are going to rip off all resources, whether chemical or natural. It is equally harmful. We need to consume less. That's also the answer. Meanwhile, Sudeep also asked me that why is chemical dyes harmful? So for this, if anybody wants to know, there is a proper document that I need to share with you about the chemicals which are used in every process of chemical dyes. I cannot answer this question on here. So you can write to me on email. I can send you this table which will give you the names of the chemicals used, and you can Google on the website and see, or just Google the harmful effects of textile chemical dyeing, and you will get innumerable articles about that. Our last speaker also spoke about azo dyes, which are completely cancerous and are not allowed in exports, which is used in cheaper quality chemical dyes. The direct dyes is one of the worst dyes, and it is a cheaper dye. All the cheap textile products in the market are dyed with direct dyes, which are very, very harmful and carcinogenic. And then somebody asked here, Deepthi asked me that to talk about the disposal of leftover natural dyes after dyeing and how it affects our water resources. So Deepthi, the material, the liquid and solid waste that comes out of natural dyes is absolutely eco-friendly. The liquid waste can go in the water, and just like in water, there are organisms that can digest and clean the water. This is food. Basically, the herbs and the minerals are food for the animals. They will eat it and the water will become clean again. In our factory, we have a water recycling plant. If you want to set up a natural dyeing plant, we can show you the process of how you can make the effluent, the waste water of your natural dye unit into drinking water. It is not very difficult. You need to have a plant to clean the water and then an RO to make it drinking water. Secondly, about the solid waste. The solid waste of natural dyes is actually a manure for the soil. What is it? It is a concoction of herbs. So if you're taking herbs, concocting it, boiling it, making color, and then removing the solid, what is it? It's actually plant matter going back in the soil. As far as the mordant or the fixer is concerned, alum and iron are naturally present in the soil. So they do not pose any threat if they are used as fixers. So the plants and the minerals together, they are actually safe to be disposed. I hope I've answered your question. Yeah, Shubh Kamini, tell me, how are we supposed to continue or close the session? I think we're running out of time.
Yeah? No, we have time. You can talk more.
Okay.
Yeah.
I would love to have questions from people.
Do we have more questions? Anybody?
Is natural dyeing clothes durable? Yeah, that is a big concern and a big fear with natural dyes. We have worked with a lot of exporters, a lot of designers from around the world. And everybody, the first concern and the fear is, if you cannot wash it in washing machine, I cannot sell it in America. If you tell me it's going to bleed color, I cannot sell it in Europe. If you tell me I have to wash it with hands, it's not feasible for me. So the answer is that natural dyes do bleed. They will fade in time, but if they are done properly. So the methods, as I said, that we have been doing industrially for 20 years now. At industrial process, we have a parameter. If anybody's from textiles, it is 3 to 4. which is a very, very standard parameter even in chemical dyes. By the way, if you know that chemical dyed clothes also bleed, and what happens when chemical dyed clothes bleed, they are very toxic. Their bleeding is a big concern. Natural dye bleeding should not be a big concern. But as I said, our industrial dyed fabrics can be washed in machine. They do not stain other fabrics. Only for colors which are indigo and very dark reds, we advise you to wash once or twice with hand, and then you can put it in washing machine. So we have actually, yes, we have actually made it, we have come up to the durability parameters at True Tone Inc. I cannot talk about other natural dyes, but even if you take from any other person, if you really want to support this movement, you know, just wash a couple of times with hand, and then I'm sure you can use it in washing machine. And natural dyes fade very beautifully. You know, I have been wearing this top for more than, you know, 20-30 times. It becomes lighter shade of the same color. It looks beautiful. With one buy purchase, you actually get many shades of the same color. And if you learn natural dyeing very simply, as we teach, we call it herbal dyeing, you can actually re-dye your clothes and keep changing colors. This top was actually a peach color first. Then I dyed it with indigo. Now it's violet. If I want, I can make it black. So I'm going to get three tops with one color because it's natural dyes. Okay. Deborah. Deb is asking, yes, we can ship it overseas. As a company, True Tone Inc., we can ship anywhere in the world. We have been exporting to Australia, Europe, and America. So that's not a problem.
Hello.
Yes.
Ha, Vikas here.
Yes.
Number one, is it safe or is it advisable to use oxalic acid in natural dyeing?
Yes. Oxalic acid is not a problem.
It's not a problem. Yes.
And Vikas, I would love, see, since you have so much of passion and interest in this, I would love you to write an email and get in touch with us, because we would like to get in touch with people who are passionate about natural dyes so that we can talk more, we can connect more, and, you know, we can work with it more. So this forum may not be, you know, appropriate for answering all questions, but we can continue if you join the link and you be in touch with us. Also, I would request to you to join the Color Revolution. I'm just sharing the link. This is a form, if as a consumer, as a person who works from textile, anybody can join this, and let's make this movement bigger of demanding natural dyes in our consumable products. Sudeep is asking, what is a moderating agent used? So we are using iron and alum as moderant agents and hartaki. But many natural dyes also use heavy metals and chemical fixers. So you need to ask your natural dyer, what are they using? If it is heavy metals, it is not a good idea, because copper, chromium especially, is extremely harmful. Copper is very good in small quantity, but when you talk about big quantity, then copper becomes very poisonous. So anything which is affecting the balance of minerals and nutrients in the water to a dangerous level, toxic level, is not advisable. So you need to check with your people. Avoid heavy metals and no chemical fixers. Alum and iron are good enough. Also, Vikash asked me something that about why is it not that we so much of problems are there with natural dyes. So the thing is that nobody has industrialized the process. We have done, and we can share how you can do it on machine with proper professional, you know, requirements. But when it is done with hand in a small quantity in the traditional way, it is not viable today. It will be confusing and you know, problematic. And also the consumers have not been educated. Natural dyeing between amongst consumers has just recently in these years started growing. We know about organic cotton, but natural dyes is yet to, you know, ride its wave of you know, understanding and mass awareness. So if your consumer is not ready, how will you work with it? How will you spend money on research and come out? Most industries and designers and brand houses that we have worked with, you know what is their problem and why they do not want to switch to natural dyes, they say, is because the consumer is not asking for it? Why should I create awareness? So that is why this movement, again, the Color Revolution is a movement to make normal people, everybody who is not connected to textiles, also aware, because we consume textiles, so we should be aware. The moment we make a demand, somewhere up there, the big people, the big players, the big brands, the huge companies which make tons and tons of clothes, they need to change. Some small people changing in very low quantity is not going to bring any impact on the river. The river is the place where all the textile effluent is dumped into. Sonal, thank you so much. And your question is, pressurize the industry to clean up its act, stringent rule, but no one adheres to them. Yes, no one. The pollution department is always trying to put things in place, but nobody follows because it's not possible. The quantum of water that comes out of chemical dyes, I told you, 1 kg of clothes use 150 liters of water, 1 kg of clothes. So imagine the number of kg of clothes we have in the world today, and imagine the number of water. How do you think you will clean this water? So what the normal chemical industries, which are not even structured, what they do is they have a meter which shows to the pollution department that they are cleaning their water, which is like a very, very small percentage of their waste. And the rest, it goes without any notice, you know. So how come chemical dyes are not eco-friendly? If yes, they cannot enter. Sonal, yes, it is not eco-friendly. As I said, if you want to get a detailed report about why chemical dyes are harmful, you just need to write to me on email. We will send you a table, which is a comparison chart between chemical dyeing, the normal eco-friendly, which is with, you know, a lot of chemicals also, and the natural and the herbal, which you can keep getting purer in the process. But chemical dyes, for sure, is the most toxic one. And this is not my field, but in chemical dyes, there are various strata of dyes, you know. At the lowest strata is direct dyes, which is extremely harmful and cheap. At the highest is the VAT dye, which is a little complicated and a better dye than the direct dye. And then there is reactive dye, which is also little better than, but all of these have poison. What we need to understand is the poison is too much in a cheaper dye and less in an expensive dye. But every dye has poison. And let me tell you on record that even if any chemical dye industry cleans their water, there are 30 chemicals which cannot be cleaned as much as you try. Once they are used in water, they cannot be retrieved. So cleaning the water completely is just not possible.
Namrata ji.
Yes.
Actually, I'm just telling you that as you are selling the products and your client, sometimes what happens that our client offers for very excellent fastness. We have to make them aware, and we have to bring them into the knowledge that this is natural dye and you cannot compare it with the chemical dye.
Absolutely.
More often they compare it with the natural dye, with the chemical dyes. They compare the brightness issue and fastness issue with the natural dyes. This is never going to happen. This is, I just want to make a point that keep them, to aware them is the most important thing. Awareness among the clients.
Yeah. So you are absolutely right. And this is the point of awareness that we need to create. That is why we are doing this revolution. That is why if you look at Instagram and Facebook posts, half the posts are about informing people. And yes, you're completely right that this language is different. It's a new language. It's like comparing an orange and an apple. You need to tell people as simple as that. You can compare two apples, but you cannot compare an orange with an apple. The constituent and the raw material of both is different. And the process is different. So how can both be compared, you know? So, and at Color Ashram, we work with brands and designers and industries who want to learn this language to communicate to people. We have, as people who've also done retail with natural dyed fabric, we have a long study and research of how to communicate this to people, how to create awareness. So I'll be happy to share these with anyone. We have a course where you can actually learn about how to create awareness and communicate clearly about how to take care, what to expect from natural dyes. You're absolutely right. A new rule book, a tool book is needed to talk about explaining natural dye language. It cannot be same as chemical dyes.
Namrata, I have a question.
Yes.
As people, the Resilience Lab is working on the rivers. Yeah. Where do you think we should be vocal about this? Where should we work to towards advocacy that this, you know, people start thinking about this? And even the designers and all, they are forced to think about this as an option.
Right.
And, so where do you think, at what level do we, you know, play a role? Because we cannot get into dying ourselves.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So you can speak directly to any consumer. Tell them that if you demand natural, if you're using chemical dye, you are saying yes to the chemical dye industry, who is dropping tons of liquid waste into our river, and which is a problem for us and our people. So if you start demanding natural dye, you know, if you don't even buy, but demand, you know, create awareness, spread, talk to 10 other people and say that, you know, let's talk about just talking about natural dyes. Trust me, the industries have people all around and they are very alert to how the consumer is reacting. What do the consumer want? Consumer has a real power. If today in fashion, if we become examples, like I have been wearing natural dyed clothes for the last 10 years and that is my icon, that is the language I use. So if we start telling people that, can you demand natural dyes clothing as a consumer? And if we can share, you know, on social media platforms wearing a natural dye dress and telling that this is a dress which will not pollute the river, and I'm happy to support to clean the river. Cleaning the river has to be stopping these industries from dumping so much of waste. And these industries are only waiting to listen to the consumers. Once a consumer is awake, they will change their ways. And it's possible. As I said, we have an industry model working for 20 years, can do thousands of meters in the same machines of textiles as chemical industries. We have a solution. So if people want to change, we are very happy to share the solution.
Also, there is this issue of the colors being carcinogenic. So our skin is breathing it, and realize it or not, there are hundreds of cases of cancer coming these days, and we don't relate it to any one cause, but this can easily be one of the causes. The kind of clothes we are wearing.
Right. I did not even speak about it, Rani ji, but that is a very, very important part. So there is something called amines. I'm just going to type it in the chat so you can look it up. Today there's Google, so I don't have to really give you all answers. You can look it up. There are amines which keep releasing from chemical dyes from our clothes even after they are washed and you're wearing it throughout the life. And you are inhaling these amines all the time. If you have like a wrinkle-free finish, this finish, that finish, more harmful metals are used. The more finishes, the more harmful. Also, our skin is an open organ. You can actually close your nose and breathe through your skin. So if you imagine, it's an open organ where if chemical dyes is mixing with sweat and it is the heavy metals are percolating in your skin, it is extremely harmful. And as I said, good quality chemical dyes are not so carcinogenic because they are azo-free. But the cheaper quality, when we buy a cheap fabric, be assured it has used an azo chemical dye. And that is extremely carcinogenic for the skin. And if I can tell you, not just us, the people who work in textile industries, they are all potential cancer patients. Do we ever think about those people? That we are wearing interesting clothes, but the people who are at health risk is all the people who are making our clothes. So both ways, it is extremely harmful for the skin, yes.
So this was one level there that we can act on. Where do you think, like at the government level, where do we need to act on? You know, because this is another area where NGOs can be really active. We can push the government, we can, you know,
So there are
Ministry
two
of Textile,
Right now, I can think and we can talk about this more, but two things that come to my mind, which are very sensible things is, one is there is no subsidy on natural dye and there is an 18% GST on natural dyes.
Okay.
If it is going to be so expensive, how will people work? And this tax and this, chemical dyes and pesticides were subsidized, but it's time that natural dyes are subsidized, number one. Number two is that the awareness programs we can do amongst ourselves, but the government, we can tie up with the government to help us reach people about awareness. If the government educates people, automatically the brands, industries will change. But then we need to reach, for which the government has a lot of tools to reach mass awareness, you know. Let us just talk about natural dyes and why it is needed. People yet do not know how harmful chemical dyes are. So if we can spread, let us not talk about the chemical dyes harmfulness, fine, let's not go negative, but can we talk about natural dyes? Can we talk about the benefits of natural dye? Let that be the, you know, way to go forward. So in creating awareness, if we can have programs where government can help us to reach, and you know, we can have funding from the government to create awareness, public awareness programs. And yes, again, if we can have subsidy and lesser taxes on the dyes, as I said, 18% GST on the dyes.
Yeah.
And I would love all of you to be in, please kindly fill out the form of Re-Evolution. So I will have your data and I would like to add you in my mailing list. You can follow us on Instagram and let us be together in this movement to demand natural dyes. Yeah. And any of you wanting to learn to do it in your house or in your industry, please do write to us. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you, Raniji and the People Resilience Lab for hosting this. Yeah.
Do we have any more questions? So Shubh Kamini.
Nabila asked that why is acid dye not banned in India? It is so harmful. Because India has a lot of strata of, you know, a lot of pockets levels, you know, in the consumer level. And it'll come slowly. So we usually do what happens in Germany and then many years later we adopt it. So in Europe, azo dyes are banned. We cannot export. We are still following. We are still using because we have cheaper textiles. We have needs to make cheaper textiles. Someday we will also ban. We always follow what the West does first. So yeah. But let me tell you, in natural dyes, India is actually the leader. There are so many knowledge hubs and artisans and the knowledge of natural dye in India that we are the leaders in natural dye. We're not the followers. But we can only be leaders if we use it and if we demand it. Thank you so much, Shubh Kamini and Raniji and People Resilience Lab.
Thank you, Namrata. Hello.
Yeah.
Okay.
See you. Bye, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. And again, I'm just sharing the link again. If you join the revolution, we'll be in touch with you. Thank you.
Yes,
we need all the support from everyone for this movement.
So thank you all the participants and both the speakers, Namrita and Atish ji, for this enlightening discourse on natural dye. And we are going to be in touch with both of you because this is something which we really feel about, which we feel that needs a lot of work. And we are going to be constantly on it. We are going to do everything. We are going to work with the artisans here. We are going to work with the government as well. We are going to push the government. We are going to write to the government. You know, whatever way possible, but this is something which we want for our rivers and for us, for our own health.
Thank you. Yeah, a big good luck sign. And Atishji, it was very nice to listen to you. I mean, you covered most of the points. I just repeated them. Thank you.
Yeah. So thank you everyone for joining us. And tonight again, we are going to have a session at around, in the evening, we are going to have a session at 6 o'clock. We have a scientist who turned into a farmer and we are going to see her journey, how she did that, why she did that. And we also have a lot of questions. Many of us are also like that we do not want a 9-to-5 job. Let's go back to farming. So she will be the one who will be answering all the questions. What was her journey? What she faced? What are the challenges she's currently facing? There are many things. Not everything is rosy, but let's meet at around 6 on the same link. And let's hear her story. Tomorrow, we are going to have a session on, what is it, Shubhi, tomorrow?
Hello.
Yeah.
Tomorrow we have climate change topic.
And also sustainable menstruation. And brushless and cashless menstrual periods. So this is the second thing which we are going to have tomorrow. Right?
Yes.
So
yes.
All are invited for our sessions. We are working towards cleaner Champa. We are working towards cleaner rivers. So all are welcome. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Namrata.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank bye-bye. You, Adi, you. Thank yeah. you. Okay. Bye-bye. Yeah.
We'll be in touch.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
धन्यवाद.
हम लोग और भी ऐसा सेशन करते रहेंगे, अवेयरनेस फैलाते रहेंगे और एक दिन जरूर सफल होंगे हम लोग कुछ कंट्रीब्यूट करने में.
बहुत अच्छा इन्फॉर्मेशन आज मिला है, बहुत बेहतरीन सब इन्फॉर्मेशन मिला है. नेचुरल डाइट से रिलेटेड बहुत सारा इन्फॉर्मेशन मिला है.
बस कोशिश कर रहे हैं हम लोग.
और ये जानकर आश्चर्य हो रहा है कि 18% मतलब नेचुरल डाई पे, जो नेचुरल डाई है इस पर 18% और केमिकल पेस्टिसाइड्स पर इतना कम है ये जीएसटी. बहुत इस पर तो बात उठाना ही पड़ेगा इस चीज को लेकर के. जब सस्ता होगा तभी तो ये पहुंच में, अगर महंगा होगा बात होना चाहिए जरूर इस चीज पर.
हाँ, तो इस पे जब तक हम लोग जानेंगे नहीं, जो लोग इस पे काम कर रहे हैं तब तक हमें समझ नहीं आएगा ना.
हाँ.
कि हाँ क्या क्या दिक्कतें आ रही है. हाँ, तो धीरे धीरे अच्छा है हमारा, हम लोग कोशिश कर रहे हैं इन्फॉर्मेशन इकट्ठा करने का कुछ.
अच्छा है, डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली फायदा तो होगा ही, नेचर को ही अच्छा लगेगा और नदियां भी बचेंगी, ऑब्वियस सी बात है.
ठीक है, हम एंड कर रहे हैं मीटिंग का. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.